A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 19th May, Sunday. On the front page you have Ashok Lavasa pulls out of poll panel meetings on model code. So this is regarding an election commissioner, Ashok Lavasa. He has pulled out of the meetings of the election commission on the model code because he had sought inclusion of his dissent notes in the decisions which the Central Election Commission takes. But Central Election Commission says that it is an avoidable controversy. So Mr. Ashok Lavasa says that my various notes on the need for transparency in the recording and disclosure of all decisions, including the minority view, have to be, have gone unheeded, forcing me to withdraw from participating in the deliberations on the complaints. Then on page 8 you have $150 million World Bank loan likely for rebuild Kerala. So World Bank is going to provide loan to the Kerala, Rebuild Kerala initiative. So talks will be held with Kerala government and Union Department of Economic Affairs on this. So this development policy loan is to be secured for $150 million. So the final so the working out will be done on this loan, how this loan would be provided, the final tranche of the DPL and the conditions for repayment. That the terms and conditions will be finalized now. Then this is hardly any water even for Abhishek in Dharmshala. So this is regarding Dharmshala, which is a well-known pilgrimage center on the foothills of Western Ghats. So this is not Dharmshala of Himachal Pradesh, this is a Dharmshala in Karnataka. So it is under water crisis so much that the temple does not have water even for the Abhishek. So it is asking devotees to postpone their visit to the temple now. And below you have World Heritage Site tag may continue to elude Hyderabad. So the National Monuments Authority has given the go-ahead for development of 54 row houses in the regulated zone of 500-year-old Golconda Fort and Qutub Shahi tombs complex in Hyderabad. So these are likely to come up between Golconda Fort and Qutub Shahi tombs, the row houses. So there is a concern here because if such steps are taken, then World Heritage Site status for the site of old Golconda, that may not be possible. Then on international page you have UK law secures rights of Sikhs to carry kirpans. So UK government has amended its weapons bill, has been introduced and it has been amended to allow Sikhs to carry kirpans and use it during religious and cultural functions. So offensive weapons bill as such has got the royal assent. And this is US lifts metal tariffs on Canada and Mexico. So President Donald Trump announced a deal to lift US tariffs on steel and aluminium imports from Canada and Mexico. So this is it. So Canada and Mexico agreed to withdraw all complaints lodged against US at WTO, and the tariff which was imposed last year, 25% on steel and 10% of aluminium, which was a major stumbling block for ratifying the new North American trade agreement too. So this issue has been resolved now. The tariffs have been lifted by USA. Then on business page you have RBI now uses divergence to compel banks to improve their loan loss ratios. So at least three public sector banks we have seen have reported earnings for the Jan to March quarter mentioning divergence in bad loan recognition. So divergence here actually means that RBI has found that the bank has underreported or not reported at all bad loans in a particular year. So then RBI asks the lender to make disclosures if underreporting is more than 10% of bad loans or the provisioning. So when there are bad loans, banks have to make a provisioning of a certain percentage of that amount of loans which they know they cannot, they will not be able to recover. So this divergence is now being used by RBI for banks to improve their loan loss ratios. Then on Sundays you have this FAQ, frequently asked questions, so important issues are covered here. So first one is climate risk protocols. So this says why UN-led investors have drawn up a guide for firms to rethink threat to companies. Actually 20 institutional investors from 11 countries convened by the UN Environment Finance Initiative made a public report that helps investors understand how to calculate the risk companies face from climate change. So the key factors that have necessitated this new protocol is discussed here. So climate risk also has to be factored in. And this is, why has the US raised trade war stakes? So what are the causes and consequences of the heightened tariff battle between Trump administration and China is detailed out here. You can see the entire timeline given here too. And this is, what is India's stand on data storage? So as US talks tough against data localization, India has called in for data localization. So what are the protection regulations in place in India, and what is India's stand and what lies ahead? So that is discussed here. For e-commerce companies also, India insists on data localization, means data on Indian customers, Indians as such, should be located on servers within the country. While, you know, multinational e-commerce companies, they want data to be on the servers of their home country, and a copy would be provided here, but Indian government insists on data to be on the servers in India itself, not a copy. Then on Sundays, you have a science and technology coverage. So here one is, IIT Bombay fabricates wearable supercapacitor. So this is a wearable supercapacitor which can store and deliver large amount of electrical energy exceeding other similar devices. So it can store the energy storage device. So it can be stitched onto any fabric, and it can deliver power ranging from microwatts to milliwatts, which can be used for powering GPS devices or an LED, etc. And this is, hornbills among top sea dispersers most threatened. So a study was carried out in Pakke Tiger Reserve in Arunachal, where it was found that hornbills are among the top sea dispersers and they are most threatened too. Then on the last page, you have environmental costs of a digital planet. So this is regarding the share of emissions from information and communication technology. So it is said this would rise from 2.5% in 2013 to 4% in 2020. So technology, which is a solution to world's environmental challenges, is also part of the problem because of the, you know, the environmental emissions which they cause. So here you can see, it says around 25 watts per hour, representing 20 gram of carbon dioxide emissions, take place. You know, so this is what takes place when 293 billion emails are sent every single day of a year. So the power needed to generate power needs to be generated mostly from fossil fuels. So whenever electronic devices are used, it results in power being consumed, and this power is generally through electricity, which is generally produced through fossil fuels. So that is the environmental cost or costs of a digital planet detailed out. So these are the important headlines. Thank you.